Trump dummy, Trump dummy, Trump dummy. This lace is extremely too dark. It's not really dark, more so of probably just grayish. Whose skin is gray? So I'm gonna take my Amon Press powder. You guys have seen me use this a numerous amount of times here on my channel. Did mention to you guys need a skin tone, flesh tone powder when you guys are installing your units, just in case. And this is the perfect time that I need, so it's right here. You're gonna wanna take a fluffy brush. Nothing that's too dense, because you wanna be able to have a lot of control. You rather have too less of powder on your lace so that you can build it up, rather than putting too much powder on your lace and not being able to take it off. Baby, that's even worse than having dark lace. I'm gonna just lightly pat into this, and I would recommend more so of an eyeshadow brush for this. I'm gonna take a little bit and I'm just going to wipe like that, and instantly you can kind of see where it's kind of trying to melt into my skin. I'm just gonna pull the hair over so you can kind of see, and kind of brush down. You're gonna brush down into your face so that it can blend really good. I'm gonna save this right here for last, because I'm gonna show you guys how to get rid of that white cast as well. Really simple, really easy. Probably already know how, but I'm gonna show you anyway. Now my ear tabs are a little bit too high up, which is why I kind of tried to camouflage it with like some long ear tabs on the sides. And you also want to make sure you're not neglecting the lace that's right here behind around your ear. That also can make it look a little bit wiggy, and this just makes it look a lot more natural, as you can see, honey. And it looks darker right here because this is dried up spray. I'm gonna show you guys how to take that off. Now you can see that the lace is looking a lot more natural and scalp-like. Looks more like it's coming out of the root by me just adding the powder on the front of the lace. Now,
you don't stop there.
Because if you part the hair, you can still see kind of where it's a little bit gray at. So now you're gonna get into the little nitty-gritty and part your hair here and there, and put the powder in between little crevices and parts like this. So that way the wig can look a little bit more scalp-like. You don't have to go all through your head, but I'm just gonna get into where I know I like to flip my hair at, just to make sure I'm unclockable. And this also helps if you have over-bleached knots.
Y'all know I'm the queen of an over-bleached knot.
Thank you. know I'm gonna go with the middle part. I did kind of want a side part, but after I saw how deep this part was right here, y'all know I'm fiending. The install process was really easy. I do feel like though I may have tightened up my straps in the back a little bit too much, which is why my ear tabs are kind of receding back into my actual hairline. That's not a problem. It don't bother me. I'm not gonna keep this wig on long anyway, so it's not really gonna hurt anything. Everything is looking so good. I'm loving my hairline. I'm loving my baby hair. I did not know how I was gonna feel about these just two little awkward edges right here, but I think it's a vibe. It's a vibe. I'm gonna go ahead and flatten out the top of my head, straighten out my hair. You guys see me do it 1,001 times. I'll leave a video on how I straighten my hair down below, as well as how I get my wig super flat at the top down below in the description box, and also somewhere up here in the card. Those videos are kind of old. If you guys want an updated straightening, an updated wig on flat video, let me know down below and I'll get that up for y'all. Yeah, I'll be back. Guys, this is how everything ended up turning out. Now I do want to point out real quick that the clips that you guys saw of me doctoring up the lace was about 3 to 4 days ago. So I am working with like almost a week old wig. I've been just touching her up here and there as I go. So she's not looking as fresh, but sis is still cute. Sis is still giving, you know, very much so scalp. Just wanted to point that out. If you see some little rough patches, just so you guys know, I've been wearing her for a couple days. I mean, I have not been the nicest to sis, so we're trying to get along, trying to get reacquainted with each other. If you guys actually want a maintenance or touch up video, I would definitely be interested in filming that for you guys, because I do have a little bit of a routine when it comes to touching up my wigs and everything. So I don't mind sharing that with you guys, because I know that is very, very important when you are a part of wig life. Y'all let me know down below. Anyways, but to this hair. If I have not stated already, this hair is from Jolie She. Jolie She is also formerly known as African Mall. If you guys are not familiar with African Mall, they typically specialize in wigs and also clothing. But for today's look, they did send your girl their 22 inch straight lace wig. This is a lace front, and I want to say this is a pretty long part, but it's not super duper long, so I'm not gonna say 6 inches. This may be a 13 by 4 13 by 5. Y'all know how I do. I put everything over here on this side of the screen or this side of the screen. Y'all know, if y'all are OG Beehive gang members, gang, then you know. As I stated previously, I did not show you guys how I straighten or flatten out top of this wig. I'll leave links to those videos, show you specifically how I straighten and silk out my units and how I get my wig super duper flat, because sis is on flat. I'll leave those videos down below. This hair was extremely easy to straighten. Y'all know recently I've been trying to try out my Garnier Fructis. Now I did use a little bit of this on this hair, but it was not used to straighten. This hair was giving this type of body and this type of silkiness and texture before I ever even touched this. So I would highly recommend this hair if you are a straight hair addict. Now, even though this hair is very silky, very flowy, very bouncy, I do want to point out that the wig wasn't really given all of that until I clipped my ends. Now this hair was initially 22 inches, but I did clip maybe, I want to say possibly a smooth inch. I just love a blunt kind of cut when it comes to my straight hair. And a good wig tip, I've mentioned this before on previous videos, but I'm gonna say it every time I get a chance. If your straight hair or your body wave hair or even your curly hair sometimes is not giving you that body, that slang time that you're looking for, that doesn't necessarily cancel out your hair as being good hair. It does not make your hair bad hair. It just means it's missing something, and normally that is a light trim. Typically when you get a trim on your hair feels lifeless, it feels limp, and you want to dust them a little bit to give them like that extra refresh, you know. And the same thing goes for your wigs and your extensions. That's typically a quality that comes with more affordable hair. So besides that, I don't have any complaints. Not even the ends is a complaint, because it's something I would have done anyway. The only qualm that I did have was the lace, but as y'all can see, that's not a problem anymore. We done got sis all the way together. I'm enjoying this unit. I know if you guys purchase it, you will enjoy this unit as well. If you guys are interested in this unit, I will leave all the links and everything down below so you guys can check it out at your leisure. Also, you guys, do not stop at this video here. Look up more videos on Jolie She hair and on this particular unit so you guys can have a little bit more knowledge on this type of texture. This is just my honest opinion. But I really recommend you guys do more research, and that way you will have a better feeling when you are making your purchase, because even though this hair is affordable, wigs ain't cheap. A big, big thank you does go out to Jelly She here for sponsoring today's video. Thank you guys for bringing today's look. I am in love with this unit. If you guys enjoyed today's video, please do not forget to give your girl a big thumbs up. And of course, subscribe to the Beehive down below. Join the Beehive gang, the Beehive fam, because we are lit and we are never, ever bougie over here. Do you understand me? I know you want to keep in contact with your girl because I'm your best friend. You're my best friend. We're all best friends. Jazzy Girl on Instagram. I mean, what? Leave sus a name down below. What is this wig giving you? Put it in the comments. The name I see reoccurring the most often, or the name that rings the most bells in my head, we will pick, and that will be the name of this wig for the future wig sale. For anyone that has been asking about my lashes that I've been wearing, these are my style and brand of lashes. I do sell lashes and lip gloss and lip scrubs on my website, The Hive & Co. I will leave the link down below in the description box so you guys can check out the site. The lashes I am wearing today are the Chanel lashes. I'll leave the link to these lashes also down below. And yeah, you guys, as always, I love every single one of you. But until next time, my lovelies, your crown, me too. But you never let it fall. Stay gilded.